Rom-com dramas, when done right, are the best kind of genres to watch. They make you feel good, tug at your heartstrings, and totally have you a believer in love. There's obviously being a lot of rom-coms out there in the Thylacon world, but very few earn the title of being the best of all times. Here's a look at 20 of those titles. Number 1, Full House. Eum is a writer who got swindled out of her house during her trip to Korea. She finds out that her house was sold to Mike, and in an attempt to get possession back, she enters a contract marriage with Mike for 1 year. Though she lost everything, Eum remains optimistic and takes things in stride. What started out as a business relationship between the two becomes personal as they start to care for each other. This is a rich boy poor girl story, as in most of the Asian dramas, but the lead couple prevented it from being boring. The two leads sold this simple story with their cute chemistry and beautiful visuals. They were too adorable and cute, especially with their bickering and cute fights. So if you're looking for cute moments and are looking for a drama that can make you laugh, then this drama is for you. Number 2, My Husband-in-Law. The smart and multi-talented Mue lives with her crush Thien for over 7 years. Although Mue loves him, Thien never seems to love Mue. Instead, he always teases her, messes with her, and sometimes bullies her. Mue never got angry or responded to Thien when she got bullied because she loved him too much. One day, Thien was forced to marry Mue just to get rid of the wife of a powerful man. As Thien never looked at Mue as his life partner, he was not really okay with the marriage. In addition, Thien wanted a perfect woman as his wife, but Mue was never perfect in his eye. Will Thien fall in love with Mue at the end, or will Mue be the perfect wife for him? The most adorable, the most cutest, and the most amazing story till now of all the Thai dramas. It had romance, thriller, action story, where you can't stop praising the writers and cast. Both the leads were great as a couple. Mark Prin just stole the drama for me with his playboy turned good husband role. Number 3, My Secret Bride. Swarm is a mischievous girl who grew up in the slums. She develops a crush on Dhanurudh, a good cop, the first time she meets him due to his good looks and kindness. Swarm is asked to become a spy for the police by an undercover deputy commander named Tuan. Her mission is to spy and gather evidence on an influential criminal named Siaha. Swarm gets involved with Dhanurudh again when he misunderstands that she is Ake's mistress, who is his cousin's fiancée. He hires Swarm to be his fake wife to keep her away from Ake. Tuan believes that this is the perfect opportunity to spy on Dhanurudh, so Swarm accepts his offer. She moves into his house pretending to be his wife because he needs her to follow his orders while she must spy into him. This one is an enjoyable show on many levels. The lead pair's unending bickering was too fun and keeps you hooked. This drama had quite a humor and I enjoyed every bit of it. All the actors played well, especially the Snow White team. Number 4, Kiss Me. Talif, a cute, lively and clumsy girl, has had a crush on a popular and genius named Tenten, who is a new student with an IQ of 200. Tenten just returned from Japan with his family. How will Talif deal with her feelings towards Tenten? Sometimes he treats her kindly and cares about her. Yet, sometimes he teases and embarrasses her in front of all the students in their school. Unlike all the other versions, which all follow the storyline almost exactly the same, Thai version managed to add a twist in the show without changing the original story of a smart, aloof genius guy and a cute, kind and a little dumb girl. However, this version adds more depth to the story. Male lead felt more complete and bearable in Kiss Me. Number 5. My Forever Sunshine. The story about Pain, a girl with a tragic life. After losing her father, she has to go live at Arthit's house. The only way for her to be able to stay at his house is to be with him. But no one expected that her approaching Arthit nearly cost him his life. He ends up hating her to the bones, and she is exiled far from home for 4 years until the day they come across each other again. One might think the time will lessen hate, but not for Arthit. Not only he still hates her, but he also hates her even more than before. But in order to keep her final promise to Arthit's father, she must endure it. Mark Prynne is one of the reasons I watch this drama. Only he can pull off these being a jerk but has a soft side for the main girl. My Forever Sunshine is truly for the young at heart. Love that makes one feel giddy, giggly and warm all over. Overall a good drama, good love story, good background songs and all the other characters' acting was also good. Number 6. Trabaap Se Chompu. Pat Sakon is the only heir of a millionaire who hides his cruel coldness under his good looks. He started to act out toward his father after his mother died. When Kang Sadan enters his life, he cannot hide his interest in this kind and sassy girl. But his world begins to twirl upside down when his father brings home the exact girl and her mother home and decides that they will live with Pete and his father as a family because of Khunsa being sick. With resentment in his heart, Pat Sakon decided to turn his back on his family. After 4 years, he returned in order to take everything back, and Kang Sadan will be the first person he takes revenge on. But throughout the series, he and Kang Sadan start to fall in love with each other. But because of his resentment towards his father for not being there for his mother, he continues to be heartless and selfish towards Kang Sadan by treating her very badly and trying to make her jealous. Number 7. Oh My Boss. When Noom Neem finally lands a solid job, she decides to have a fun night out with her friend to celebrate. At the bar, she meets a handsome stranger and spends a lovely night with him. However, that stranger turns out to be her new boss. Luckily for her, the handsome CEO doesn't seem to remember her. Or does he? When he makes Noom Neem his personal assistant, she finds herself wondering whether he is interested in her or just this flirtatious with everyone. Number 8. Princess Ars. The plot takes place in Bhutan, a fictitious country. Crown Prince In and Cunning get married due to a promise between both of their families. Before getting married to Cunning, Prince In had a close friend who is close enough to be called his girlfriend named Minnie. He had asked Minnie for her hand in marriage, but Minnie rejected him. Minnie now regrets doing so and wants Prince In back. Also, the former crown princess also wants the throne back for her son, Prince In's cousin. But as Prince In and Cunning spend time together every day, they begin to understand each other more and develop feelings for each other. How will Prince In and Cunning's love story unfold? Number 9. Ugly Duckling – The Series. Junita, nicknamed Junior, had plastic surgery because people said her face was fat. Without knowing that she was allergic to chemicals, it ruined her face by causing acne everywhere. It would take a year to fully recover. After the incident, nobody wanted to get close to her, and whoever saw her would call her a ghost face. She couldn't stand it, so she begged her mom to let her study at a college in the countryside to avoid the social life of Bangkok and to have a face treatment done by a doctor recommended by the Ugly Duckling Forum. And that's where she meets Suya, a handsome, flirty, penniless senior who is the first person to sincerely befriend her despite her looks. Number 10. You Prince Series. Sung dreams of making Kiran, from the commerce department, her boyfriend. Until one day, Sung was hit by a tricycle and made a promise with the God of Death. The God of Death sent her back to the mortal world and gave her some kind of divine power. But due to some reason, every time she had physical contact with Kiran, Sung will go into trance. Number 11. Love Destiny. Kati Surang is a modern day girl who travels back in time 300 plus years after a car accident. There, she finds herself inhabiting the body of Mei Ying Karakadi, a noble who resides with her father's best friend and his family. Much to Kati Surang's dismay, Mei Ying Karakadi is spoiled and evil. Even her dearest betrothed Pordey hates her and vows to stall their wedding for as long as possible. While there, Kati Surang does merits and good deeds to rectify the damage done by Mei Ying Karakadi, in hopes of returning to her modern-day world. In the process, she slowly wins the love and admiration of the entire village, including Pordey. Number 12. Lei Nang Fa. T-Pop and Lalalit grew up together, but he hates her. So when she comes to him for help to regain power over her family's company, he pranks her by sending her to do the lowest jobs. Lalalit is a spoiled, bratty and selfish heiress who is completely absorbed with her own beauty. Looking down from heaven, two angels decide to teach her a lesson by acting as her fairy godmothers and casting a spell on her. Only two love's kiss can break the spell. So, when she was challenged to break the spell, Lalalit thinks it would be a piece of cake to find somebody love her. But to her surprise, she overhears people talking badly about her, hating her for being rotten. Number 13. Love at First Hate. When a smart, handsome and foul-mouthed doctor, Paniti, or Dr. Pap met a hot, sexy and thick superstar, Chloe, who is not his type and also he is not her type. They hated each other at first sight. But when they have to live together, something strange happened. It looks like Dr. Pap is falling in love with Chloe. To save his face from what he said before, that she is not his type, he is trying to act not to like her. But can he? What will the ending of these two be? Haters or lovers? Number 14. Sapai Import. Lisa is a rich, spoiled girl who returned from her studies in England to find her parents were in debt. She had to work to repay that debt, and Don's mother helped her. Don is the grandson of a very famous farm owner. When Don's grandfather died, he conditionally named Don as his successor. To receive the farm, Don had to marry and have a child within a year. Otherwise, the farm would be awarded to his cousin's brother. Don's mother loved Lisa like a daughter, so she pushed them towards marriage. At first, both of them rejected the marriage. Then Don's mother announced that she was going to die soon, so Lisa accepted as a sign of gratitude. Since Don and Lisa don't love each other, they agreed to pretend to be married for 6 months. Despite their differing lifestyles, nothing could stop destiny. Number 15. Mei Krua Kon Mai. Lom Dao is supposed to marry Param, but she refuses since she's never met him and doesn't know what he's like. So she disguises herself as Fai Dan, Param's family's new cook. Param soon becomes suspicious of her, and it's just a matter of time before he discovers that she's his fiancée. Slowly, the two fall in love. Number 16. Let's Fight Ghost. A cohabitation comedy about a ghost of a high school girl who has been dead for 5 years and an exorcist college boy with the ability to see and hear ghosts. What he's discovered over the years is that he can touch them and fight them off. So when he's in need of a part-time job and can't find one that pays well enough, he starts putting ads online as an exorcist for hire. One night, he goes out on the job and faces off with a schoolgirl ghost, and during the fight, they accidentally kiss and sparks fly. Number 17. Zhao Sao Chang Yeon. Mina is a stubborn girl and a talented auto mechanic. Fufat is their heir of a company engaged in the production of auto parts. His father arranges a marriage between Fufat and Mina in hopes she will be able to heal his heart that was hurt in the past and return his interest in life. Everything seems to be going well, but suddenly, his ex returns and Fufat's younger brother begins to show interest in Meena. Number 18, Secret 7. This is the story of Padlom, a lonely girl who is afraid of love. However, one day, someone told her that a guy secretly likes her, and this guy is supposed to be among the seven young men. Follow Padlom's passionate love story, and how will Padlom find out which of the seven guys is secretly in love with her? Number 19, My Love from Another Star. An alien named Achira, who comes to Earth for research, sees a woman in trouble and decides to save her. His heroic action gets him stranded on Earth for 300 years as he was late returning to the spaceship and it left without him. With only 3 months left before his long-awaited departure, he meets actress Falada and realizes that she is the woman he saved all those years ago. Will Achira choose to return to his planet or stay on Earth after finding himself developing feelings for the famous actress? Number 20, I Wanna Be a Superstar. Wan Myung dreams of becoming a superstar, but her parents object. They want her to study abroad. Win Pakon is a famous actor who withdrew from the entertainment world after some sensitive clips involving his former manager Wan Wan were released. Win lives abroad for 5 years before returning to Thailand and buying Wan Myung's house. Meanwhile, Wan Myung is homeless. She lurks around the house that now belongs to Win. When a journalist follows Win home, he tells her to stay if she can handle the reporter. She succeeds and slowly Win transforms from fastidious and irritable to friendly. He even guides Wan Myung's acting career so that one day she may become a star. Which romantic comedy Thai drama is your ultimate favorite? Let us know in the comments down below. Also, please be sure to like, share, and subscribe. Thank you.